L'intégration des ODD,
Integrating SDG Sustainable Development Goals
dans la ville et les
in towns and territories is essential.
C'est essentiel car aujourd'hui,
it is essential because nowadays, 50% of the world population lives in towns or urban areas. It is estimated that in 2030 or maybe 2050, this percentage will climb to 60 or 70% of the world population. Huge concentrations of people, which also means concentrations of nuisance and problems for both the environment and the populations. Towns suffer from pollution, public health issues, resource issues, but also safety, disparities, and social problems. Hence, the need to think and design towns and territories differently to make them more sustainable. And to achieve this, we rely on SDGs. Towns and territories are also the spaces within which SDGs may be crossed, so that they become transversal. A number of players will be able to act in those same places, and governance may vary on a case-by-case basis. We need shared governances, governances resulting from a cross between states, economic players, but also local officials and population. And for that matter, local officials and territorial authorities are essential players to implement SDGs concretely in the territories. They're the ones who make the choices regarding planning and land use or local development strategies. And thanks to this, some transversal SDGs will be implemented regarding issues such as healthcare, energy, the fight against climate change, infrastructures, not to mention biodiversity, water or food resource supplies. To achieve this, territorial authorities have a number of tools available, especially for planning purposes. Territorial planning is defined as a tool allowing to meet sustainable development goals. It helps us formulate a medium and long-term vision of the territory while striving to rationalize infrastructures and resources. Tools are available in France, known as planning documents.
Donc on peut retrouver au niveau
locally,
local des
PLU, we have the PLUs, French for local town planning documents. On the intermunicipality level, we have the SCOTs, which are territorial consistency patterns, and more widely, the SRADETs on the regional level. These are the tools on the French territorial level, but other countries also have their own planning tools to help them move forward towards more sustainable territories, notably in the case of Colombia, where they have all kinds of instruments, ranging from the national to the local level. Note that in Colombia, municipalities enjoy a large administrative and financial autonomy in the management of planning and development policies, while reporting to the state with regard to development plans. They can still implement a number of objectives and challenges on the territorial level. Some of the SDGs fall into this category. In Colombia, a lot of work goes into preserving resources, but also fighting inequalities and fighting for employment. There is also the example of Benin. In Benin, land and town planning are a responsibility shared between the state and the municipalities. They rely on the land and town planning code, but also on two main documents. One is the land and town planning master scheme, and they also have the town planning master plan. These two documents allow territorial authorities to define visions, orientations, and for this they rely on strategic objectives, mainly the sustainable development goals that we mentioned previously. Obviously, all of this takes place under a shared governance, and bringing the population and citizens into the process, because otherwise it would be impossible to implement the SDGs in the territories and towns.
Il y a des outils également qui existent.
Some tools exist to drive certain SDGs into the planning phase. Notably with regard to ADME, the Agency for the Environmentally Controlled Use of Energy.
Pour cela, en France, on a
I'm referring to all measures relative to the fight against climate change. In France, we have two tools. The Climat Pratique,
a tool qui permet d'aider au pilotage et à définir
which helps steer
au climat,
and define the steps regarding climate and helps to put in place
climat, air, énergie,
air energy climate policies,
donc
also called PCAET. Really helpful when it comes to taking action and making SDG 13 operational. There is also CITERGI, a tool to fuel
pour faire vivre des politiques transversales,
the municipalities and intermunicipalities transverse policies. And it offers a three-level certification to reward 4 years of commitment
de qualité dans les politiques énergétiques
for quality actions taken in the climate policies. It is essential, an essential tool for local authorities to fight climate change. The CITERGI certification offers to monitor and follow how involved municipalities are in the Mayors Convention. The Mayors Convention is an international initiative converging towards Agenda 2030 for Sustainable Development and reasserting the need to implement SDGs on the global level in territories and towns. The Mayors Convention is an association which supports climate and energy-related issues on the global level in the towns and territories that voluntarily commit to take action. For instance, the Mayor's Convention for Sub-Saharan Africa is a very good example. They have decided to adjust the SDGs to the African context, working particularly on climate change issues, access to energy, health and well-being, and resilient town issues. The Mayor's Convention for Sub-Saharan Africa supports 13 towns acting as leaders in this process and integrating SDGs in the planning process. ADME is also partnering with a number of bodies and institutions to improve the way SDGs are taken in consideration in the planning process. For these strategic issues to be adopted in the operational and urban planning process, some tools help us take a number of SDGs in consideration. Let us remember that sustainable urban planning is really a way to improve quality of life and reduce disparities and also mitigate the threats bearing on towns and urban populations. Sustainable towns must rely on urban planning specifically designed for sustainable towns. And I'm going to provide a detailed description of three French tools, notably the first one, AEU2, an environmental approach to urban planning, the tool developed by ADME. The tool is a decision-making tool for political and strategic decisions related to land and urban planning. Regarding land planning, it will help us take into account a number of SDGs and, above all, anything pertaining to environmental and economic matters. There is another tool, HQE Aménagement Certification. Once new districts or buildings have been built, it will allow us to check whether everything was well thought through, notably anything with regard to energy and resources. And finally, we have the Eco-Quartier approach, a national approach which covers all types of projects and the way towns are managed. It covers all kinds of projects from urban renovation to new buildings, including rural areas or densely populated urban areas. The Eco-Quartier approach is also a commitment and a certification covering approximately 20 objectives. Interestingly, the approach can be transferred to any context in any country.
C'est pour ça qu'on
there are eco-quartier examples elsewhere in the world, for instance in China, with the Wuhan eco-quartier or eco-district, where water and resource management, as well as energy savings, were kept in mind when the district was designed. We also have the example of Santiago de Cali in Colombia, where the municipality is really willing to support some eco-barriers or eco-districts facing the economic challenge of developing green or local markets. In conclusion, we do see how important it is to work and integrate SDGs in towns and territories during the planning phase already, but also when making planning choices, quite simply because in these towns, the largest part of the global population can be reached. And here also, transversality between SDGs can be implemented, governance issues can be addressed, and all the stakeholders in the construction of towns and sustainable territories can be included.
De la ville et des territoires durables.